Boss, now
how can we make it to work?
So what would they be doing?
They're using it to pay house rent.
It's for their own sake and for our own sake.
Lagos State government has placed a ban on motorcycles and tricycles plying major highway roads in Lagos. They said this is based on security and safety reasons. I am on the streets of Lagos to get opinions of Lagosians. My name is Oyinja Mola and I am reporting for Plugtv.
All those cars just postpone all those cars too much for Lagos. If possible, just leave and make it just come up for road. It's good.
So you are saying they should ban motorcycles?
Yes.
So we should not have motorcycles in Lagos?
I don't want it again.
You don't want motorcycles?
Yes.
Again. So don't you think it will cut traffic?
Which traffic? No. Let me just enter this Lagos bus now. It's good.
It's not a good decision at all because talking about motorcycle is the one that help we workers like this, because assuming I'm working at Ogba and I'm living at Okiaru side, I don't have the strength to wake up around that 6 o'clock, so I have to wake up by 7. By that 7, I will have to board bike. I don't mind the money just to get to work early. But if they ban motorcycle and tricycle now, how can we make it to work? So I don't think it's a good idea at all.
I think there is a reason before the action is taken. If you look at it very well, you will have observed in recent times that since the commencement of tricycle and motorcycle, we have so many accidents on the way. Many people were maimed, some died in the event. And I think it's not that the government did not ban. They only asked them to go to the interior instead of them coming to the express. That express is more dangerous than when they apply the inside. You understand? Like the express, the way they are overtaking is dangerous. The way they speed is dangerous. Carrying like two or three people, you know, very, very dangerous. So the government did this not because of them, it's because of their own life, to save them and to save the passengers. Because you too, you will observe, I think you have been taking bike to where you are going. We know it has advantage and disadvantage, because some people might be living very far because of the hold up, because of the hold of the traffic. They might want to beat the traffic in order to get to their various offices early. But we look at it the other way around. I think our life is far better late than never. Yeah. So I think that is by asking them to, withdraw them from the express, it's better. It's for their own sake and for our own sake.
Banning them means that it's a bad law, because how would these people survive? Most of them depend on this transportation business to feed their families and to take care of themselves. If they know they want to ban these tricycles and motorcycles, they should find another means or another job opportunities, because in this country, to be sincere, there is no job. I finished since last year, October. I just got job this month, two good months. So what would they be doing? Most of them, they are not even a graduate. So banning them would really affect most of these people. And they should also try and look for a means of livelihood for them.
It's not too good and it's not too bad. In the sense that they are constituting a lot of nuisance on the road. Imagine a bike scratching your vehicle before you come and they run away. It's so bad. But in an area whereby there's a lot of traffic, they are very, very useful, especially when you have to meet up with a target, you understand? So it's not, but it's not a total ban. It's a restriction on some areas, some places like express, which is good for them, If you look at our roads, a lot of deaths because of Okada motorcycle, as they call them. So it's a good thing. It's not too bad. So far, it's not a total ban. So that's it. That's my take.
Well, placing a ban on motorcycle, I don't really know the effect it's going to have on Nigerians, because most persons get to use the bikes to get to their destination. And most times when you come out from a street where it's far to your bus stop to get a bus to where you're going to. So what happens when the motorcycle is being banned and you don't have a private vehicle to convey you to where you're going to? That means the person has to trek a far distance before he gets to his bus stop. So I think they should like review what they are trying to do. Probably they should not allow the motorcycles or tricycles ride on highways. They should ride in the streets. I think that's what I think about it.
It's a very welcome development. But one thing the state government should be considered is that those by motorcyclists, the trade is for their major sources of income. But if you all look at the other side, the opaque and everything, they are still working on the highway. But why can't the state government tell them to should inculcate from the OPEC, being using of element and all those protective elements, in order to, you know, to be road to be safe and for their work to be easier, for state government to lay embargo on such motorcycles. No, after they have laid embargo on it, the motorcyclists are just forced to the labor market, and the wish is there's no employment. And to the masses, many people will wake up early for them to build traffic and every other things, they have to board bike. But when there's embargo on this thing now, you will see that most of the there will be road congestion, more traffic in Lagos State.
In fact, it's going to bring a very bomb blast to our people. But this motorcycle in particular are feeding many people. They're using it to pay house rent, feed their children, even to university level. So is the government going to create job opportunity for them? That's what we're talking about. Then what they want them to do. So we don't know what the outcome will be like.
What I think about it is that they are doing what they want to do in their state. So nobody can blame them. Nobody can stop them for doing what is right and what they wish to do by themselves. So every other state can do so.
It can't work out because it will turn to another thing. Because people riding tricycle and motorcycle also, they have family to feed. No work, most of them, I even know most of them, they are graduates. Most of them, we went to school together. Because as I am, I'm an end holder. But I'm doing just casual work, the work I learned. So I don't think that is the best way for Lagos State government to come around with all this rubbish. I don't think that is the best way at all.